We've been reporting on the record turnout this election of black and brown voters, which helped impact the political process, especially in battleground states like Georgia and Pennsylvania. Now, with the election over, many of the organizers who helped register thousands of those voters say the fight is far from over and want Democrats to deliver on centering marginalized voices. NewsHour Weekend's Ivette Feliciano has more.
In the run-up to the November elections, members of United We Dream, the largest youth-led immigrant rights organization, reached out to tens of millions of undecided Latinx and first-time voters across the country through phone banking and digital ad campaigns.
I know that, like, people like myself that have DACA have U.S. citizens in our families, that we had them and asked them to think about us when they went into the voting booth.
Gresa Martinez Rosas is United We Dream's executive director.
The record turnout of Latinos, of young people, of black and brown folks have been as part of like the long-term investment of organizers like myself, people in Arizona, Michigan, Pennsylvania, Wisconsin. So, I think that there's work to do and we will not stop until we tell the story about how this turnout wasn't an accident.
The black and brown turnout did not go unnoticed, as President-elect Joe Biden acknowledged in his acceptance speech last Saturday night.
The African-American community stood up again for me. You've always had my back, and I'll have yours.
I'm not one for empty platitudes. The Democratic Party owes a great deal to the black electorate, and it's time to pay up that tab.
Black Lives activist and writer Sherelle Brown is based in Atlanta, Georgia, where politician Stacey Abrams is credited with delivering hundreds of thousands of votes for the Democratic Party.
There will be a number of articles that praise Stacey Abrams, that praise black and brown voters, but whether that translates into actual material benefits for those same communities is still the question.
Brown recently wrote an article for Essence magazine where she argues Biden's proposals for addressing anti-black state violence aren't radical enough.
The right has done this really wonderful job, actually, of painting President-elect Biden and Vice President-elect Kamala as this very anti-cop socialist ticket. But nothing could be farther from the truth. Biden and Harris both support giving more funding to police for things like anti-bias trainings or to diversify the force.
According to the American Election Eve poll 2020, which surveyed more than 15,000 registered voters, black voters named discrimination and racial justice as the second most important issue candidates should address after the coronavirus pandemic.
If only whites had voted, President Trump would have been reelected with about 56 or 57% of the vote.
Gary Segura co-founded the polling and research firm Latino Decisions, which helped produce the American Election Eve poll 2020. He's also the dean of the Luskin School of Public Affairs at UCLA. He says the media's homing in on Trump's success with Latinx voters in Miami-Dade County in Florida and the Rio Grande Valley in Texas paints a misleading picture of this year's Latinx voting bloc.
You're talking about a population that voted about 70-30 in favor of Vice President Biden. We think that Puerto Ricans probably gave as much as 71% of their vote in Florida to Vice President Biden. But it gets overlooked in Orange County and along the I-4 corridor because we spend all of our time talking about Cubans and Venezuelans and Dade.
Segura says, though Latinos voted in higher numbers for Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton, 7 out of 10 voted for Biden in November, which is still above the historical average.
The Latino margin will exceed the victory margin in Nevada and Arizona and New Mexico and Colorado. Latinos will have elected Senator Hickenlooper, Senator Lujan, and Senator Kelly. We think Latinos gave over 120,000 vote margin to Vice President Biden in Philadelphia in the Southeast Pennsylvania region, which means without Latino votes, you would not have had the vice president carried Pennsylvania. This is also true for African Americans, of course. So like in all victories, there are many owners, right?
Both Sherelle Brown and Gresa Martinez Rosas say a Biden presidency might mean more favorable conditions for their political organizing, but their fight is far from over.
Look at what's possible when people feel that they are part of the voting process, right? What Democrats should do instead of diluting the message or spinning away from their most consistent and loyal voting bloc is opening up more pathways for folks to be a part of the process.
How do we make sure that we are ensuring that Black folks and immigrants and queer people and women are not only being heard, put part of policy agendas, but as a culture, ensuring that there's restitution for those of us that have been directly in the target of Trump, which is why it's going to be so important to heal as a nation, to ensure that we are owning of the things that happened on our collective watch, and to be really committed to bold shifts in our society.